Last time, Barbara staged a breakdown to get some alone time with James Bradley, but Vic arrived to play the third wheel. Bandits showed up and shot Bradley, but were chased off by the Black Whip, who also got shot. Before he died, Bradley admitted he and Vic had been longtime partners and gave his blessing to Vic and Barbara becoming a couple. Later, the Black Whip succumbed to his own injuries and died, leaving Barbara to take over the family jobs of newspaper editor and bondage accessory spokesperson. Bandits tried to hijack a shipment with a new newspaper press and captured Vic in the process. Barbara, as the Black Whip, chased the bandits down, but not before they sent the cart with both Vic and the new press careening over a cliff. Last time, Vic escaped his doom through a shot not included in the previous episode. He receives an obscene phone call and ends his date with Barbara early to take the caller up on the offer. When Vic finds the wrong kind of rough trade, he has to be saved by Barbara in her guise as BDSM queen, the Black Whip. Meanwhile, the scheming Mr. Hammond is exploring power games with his men when the Black Whip interrupts. She gets locked inside a vault with a keg of gunpowder that proceeds to explode. Last time, the Black Whip escaped from a sealed vault with an exploding keg by closing an extra door. Vic was accused of robbing Mr. Hammond's safe and arrested. Barbara recycled footage to see if she could remember the path the real bandits took in the previous episode and maybe reclaim the stolen money. Meanwhile, a mob of the worst actors gathered to lynch Vic, struggling to decide which of their wooden performances would serve as the gallows. The Black Whip managed to steal the money back from the bandits, but was knocked from her horse on her way back to town. Last time, Vic was saved from hanging when the Black Whip delivered one of the real thieves. Vic then tried to take the bandit on a romantic carriage ride, but was interrupted by the thief's cohorts. The driver got shot, and Vic was knocked out, sending yet another carriage careening out of control. Last time, Vic survived falling over a cliff in a carriage by... surviving falling over a cliff in a carriage! Then the bandits followed the Black Whip back to Barbara's house and held her at gunpoint, but she stayed frosty and freed herself with sewing scissors. Vic and the Whip ended up at the bandits' hideout, where the bandits held Vic at gunpoint, demanding that the Whip remove her mask. Last time, BDSM icon the Black Whip escaped having her identity revealed by snatching the bandits' gun, like the writers just stopped caring about the drama. Barbara and Vic meet prospector Zeke after he struck gold, and then Barbara invites Vic to dinner while making suggestive hand gestures. Hammond sends his goons to jump Zeke's claim, but Vic and Barbara arrive just in time to save him. Vic sends Zeke to rest in his tent, and Hammond's goons throw a lit keg of gunpowder at it after the Black Whip goes inside. Last time, the Whip escaped being blown up by walking through the other side of the tent, while Vic woke up to be a useless grinning idiot. Then the writers got bored and decided to send everyone out of town. Wide shots of a wagon train being attacked ensue, and the Whip got knocked off a cliff when she arrived to help. Last time, the Whip fell off a cliff into a passing wagon, and Vic got tied up the way he liked. Then the writers went on holiday, and we got a clip show of Vic being useless. Hammond has Vic taken prisoner to force Barbara to reveal the identity of the Whip. When she sneaks back to untie him, the bandits spot her and open fire on what's obviously just her boots at the bottom of some curtains. Last time, bandits opened fire on a pair of boots sitting under a curtain. Then Hammond realized that Barbara is the Black Whip because the writers had just given up. Vic literally fell into the cave of the Black Whip and did what he'd always dreamed of doing, put on Barbara's clothes. He went to rescue Barbara and got beat up. Then the bandits set off a landslide, collapsing the hideout with Vic and Barbara inside. Last time, Vic and Barbara escaped a landslide by climbing out a window that seems wouldn't have helped them escape. The bandits steal all the horses from the surrounding areas, and Vic uses one of the bandits' horses to find their hideout. Vic is almost competent, but that's just a fake-out, and Barbara has to save him because, side note, Barbara is a badass. However, in the fight, Barbara gets pitchforked by one of the bandits. Last time, the Black Whip was stabbed with a pitchfork. We saw her legs twitch. She was dead, but somehow Vic threw a saddle between the whip and the pitchfork at the last minute, saving her life. Vic and Barbara set up a plan to make Hammond reveal himself, but Vic gets captured, because he's useless. The Whip goes to save Vic, but they get trapped in a tunnel with an exploding oil barrel. Last time, Vic and the Whip survived being trapped in a tunnel with an exploding oil barrel by climbing into a minecart like it was a fridge in a nuclear explosion. Hammond got caught, but escaped from horny jail just before the citizens descended for the erotic election. When Hammond learned he was about to lose the election, he gathered his band of sovereign citizens to stop the steal. The Whip arrived with reinforcements, but Hammond tracked her back to her hideout to take revenge, only to get stomped to death by her horse. Idaho became a state, Vic remained useless, and because there was just a minute left, the serial finally became racist.